morning, freshmen, and good morning, guests joining us virtually. My name is Justin Smith, and I'm one of the assistant principals at Blackman High School. Today, I'm joined by Dr. Lisa Justice, our principal, and Ms. Amanda Schneider, one of our school counselors. Welcome to this year's Freshman Awards Ceremony. We're excited to celebrate the achievements of these top students this morning. Traditionally, the ninth grade year is one of the most difficult years in a student's education. Ninth grade brings a unique set of changes and transitions and challenges unmatched by most years in school. When you consider this reality and compound it with all of the challenges that you face through most of your middle school years, that makes these accomplishments even more impressive this year. Congratulations. We look forward to celebrating you, and we look forward to your achievements and your leadership in our school in the years to come. Students, this is a formal ceremony, so please be on your best behavior and please put your phones away as we acknowledge the achievements of your peers. We will now begin with our departmental awards. Students, if your name is called, please quickly come to accept your award from Dr. Justice and then wait for a picture to be made by one of our student photographers. I'll now begin with the English awards. Ms. Slocum presents the English 1 award to Ashley Torres. She writes, "Not only is Ashley intelligent and takes initiative, but her presence also lights up a room every day. One thing I will remember about her the most is that she would say, 'Hi, Ms. Slocum,' every time she entered the classroom. Ashley is independent, but also a great leader in her school and personal life. She embodies all the qualities to succeed in life. I have the privilege of having her as a student." Congratulations. Ms. Henderson presents the Honors English 1 Award to Savannah Hall. Ms. Henderson says that Savannah has been an awesome contributor to our classroom this year. She comes to class ready to engage each and every day, and I greatly appreciate her kindness and work ethic.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Presenting the English 1 BCA Award to Annalyn Trail. Ms. Cunningham writes that Annalyn has an intellectual curiosity that she brings to class that enhances our class discussions and investigations of different texts. She is thoughtful and kind to her peers and brings an excellence to our studies that we all benefit from. Ms. Jackson is presenting the English Language Development Award to Micah McNair. Ms. Jackson writes that Micah has been an exemplary student in the classroom. She has improved and therefore encouraged the rest of the students in her class to step up and try harder. She relishes challenges and does her best at everything she does. She's involved in JROTC and track as well. I can't wait to see what the future holds for Micah. Christian Herrera receives the Newcomer Award from Mr. West. He writes, "Christian works extremely hard. Even when I commend him on his work, he often replies that he will only accept perfection. There's no other student in my class who shows as much interest or as much dedication to learning English. He's extremely attentive and curious about everything. He asks great questions in and outside of class about learning English as well as other parts of life. If he continues with this attitude, I can foresee him doing great things with his life." Congratulations. Yusuf Mikhail receives the ELD 9 Award from Mrs. Paris. She writes, "I've seen a lot of growth and maturity from Yusuf as he has gone throughout this year. He is always engaged in class, and he does not hesitate to help other students when they need it. He is continually seeking ways to improve. And now, the math awards. Mrs. Workman is presenting the Integrated Math 1 Honors BCA Award to Maya Williams. Mrs. Workman states, "Maya continues to impress me with her math knowledge and skills. She brings a lot to the table during class discussions and is always willing to help others. I look forward to seeing where her talents take her. Maya, you will do great things in your life. Thank you for allowing me to be a part of it." Mr. Kinney presents the Integrated Math 1 Honors Award to Freddie Brock. Freddie scored the highest of all Integrated Math 1 Honors students with an exceptional intellect and great work ethic. The math department looks forward to seeing Freddie's potential in the next 3 years. TT is the recipient of Mr. Kyle's Integrated Math 1 ESL Award. He writes that she is an outstanding student and young lady. She is hardworking, intelligent, friendly, and kind. She is everything you would want in a student. Mr. Bennett is presenting the Integrated Math 1 Award to Manny Creek. Manny works harder than any other freshman math student. In addition to doing her regularly assigned assignments, she is constantly challenging herself with tough extra credit questions on Delta Math. She isn't satisfied just by getting a good grade, but pushes herself to understand and apply the material to complex situations. Mr. Bennett says, "I know Manny will someday use her knowledge and abilities to make a difference in the world." Mrs. Brown is presenting the Integrated Math 2 BCA Award to Viola Bachtel. She writes, "Viola is an active learner who applies herself to her work consistently and diligently." Congratulations. Now, Ms. Amanda Schneider, one of our school counselors, will present the Science Awards.
Good morning, students and parents joining us digitally. The first award was given by Mr. Workman to Charlie Catron. He writes that Charlie Ann goes above and beyond in everything she does here at BHS. She comes to class with a smile every day and really sets the tone for class, that we are here to work and have fun. Charlie Ann is a positive role model for students and adults alike. She is the winner of the Honors World History Award. She is hardworking and dedicated. I have like five more sentences. She has a perfect class average and exceeds beyond class expectations on all assignments. Her excitement and dedication has been contagious for students and teachers alike. It has been a joy to have her in our class. The next award is for Allie Lawrence. Mr. Workman is presenting the Honors World History Award to Allie Lawrence. Allie has shown tremendous work ethic every day in class, whether in school or at home on Schoology. Allie works hard and always does her best. She is a winner of the Honors World History Award for numerous reasons. Allie has a tremendous work ethic and takes great pride in her work. She's taken initiative and demonstrated leadership skills as well as problem solving to master the curriculum as a distance learner. Allie has met these challenges as a polite and respectful young lady. It's been a joy to have her in my class. The next student receiving an award is Lydia Tonsamai. Ms. Rose is presenting the World History Award to Lydia Tonsamai. Ms. Rose says Lydia is a joy to have in my class. She is always a hard worker and a great listener. One thing about Lydia is she goes above and beyond in every assignment, and that has to do with drawing. I cannot wait to see her work in a gallery one day. The next award goes to Ashley Torres. Ms. Rose is presenting the World History ESL Award today to Ashley Torres. She writes, Ashley is such a hard worker and is constantly supporting her classmates around her. I know she will change the world for better one day. I look forward to continuing to watch her grow as a student and a great human being. The next award goes to Maya Williams. The AP Human Geography Award for Ms. Giacobbe goes to Maya Williams. Ms. Giacobbe says, Maya is one of those students who is quiet, kind of flies under the radar, but produces beautiful work of the highest caliber, and her grades in human geography reflect that. She says she will miss having her in her class and hopes to see her again in the future. Congratulations. Our next student is Filin Mendoza Zuniga. She may be out today, but I would like to read the statements that Mr. West has prepared. She is one of my most dedicated students. She works extremely hard and almost always participates in class. I've greatly enjoyed having her in my world history class, and she's very personable and makes an effort to be friends with everyone. During class time, she has often been seen around in her chair helping students around her. And now we're going to move to the Science Awards. Our first student is Freddie Brock. Ms. Cravey presents the Honors Biology Award to Freddie Brock. Freddie is a joy to have in class and is always an active participant. Mrs. Cravey states, I enjoy the information he adds to class discussions. His work ethic is something seldomly seen and is a pleasure to witness. Congratulations. Our next winner is Jack Syatt. Ms. Dabney is presenting the BCA Biology Award to Jack Syatt. Jack is a standout student who takes pride in his work. Although his handwriting is sometimes difficult to read, what he writes is well thought out and consistently correct. In addition to his academic aptitude, he's one of the sweetest, most fun-loving kids Ms. Dabney has ever had the pleasure of teaching. Congratulations. Our next winner is Emma Petzik. The Honors Environmental Science Award from Mr. Connor goes to Emma Petzik. She is a student who's worked diligently to the best of her ability all year. She is eager to learn, thorough in her work, and respected by her peers. With pride and honor, the Honors Environmental Science Award goes to Emma Petzik. One last science winner, and it's Gwendolyn Hill. I'll read what Mr. Connor wrote about Gwendolyn. The Environmental Science Award goes to Gwendolyn Hill. Many times, a stronger leader is not always the loudest. There are ones that are dependable, hardworking, and charismatic. Her leadership skills are proven in the classroom and in JROTC. With pride and honor, this award goes to Gwendolyn Hill. Now, Mr. Smith will present the World Language Awards.
Sorry.
Mr. Dietz is presenting the French One Award to Ethan Carson. Ethan has been an exemplar student throughout the course of this class. He not only has one of the highest averages among all students in French One, but has demonstrated a genuine interest and natural ability with the French language. He even saved his family trip earlier this year by using skills gained in class to help navigate while traveling. Kudos, Ethan. Mr. Dietz is presenting the French One Honors Award to Ella Russell. With a consistently strong work ethic, positive attitude, and genuine passion to learn French, Ella has one of the highest averages among her peers. Her passion for language is demonstrated every day in class. She is bright and inquisitive while remaining humble and willing to grow as a student in person. She strives daily to perform her best and is always willing to take a chance while speaking and applying new concepts. Mr. Dietz says that it is my privilege to present this award. The Spanish One Honors Award is presented to Dora Whitaker. Ms. Buzard says, Dora is a real pleasure to have in class. She was a freshman this year and comes well prepared and is always willing to be a good example and help others in class. She's an exceptional student who's very attentive and dedicated to showing her best each day. She goes the extra mile to ensure that she submits quality work in a timely manner. She shows an intermediate ability to understand and use Spanish. She was one of the winners of the Wacky Wall Challenge, which is a special test of 150 terms that are posted within the classroom walls, and she received a 100% score. I'm hoping to see her again when she takes Spanish 3 Advanced Honors. Spanish 3 Advanced Honors Award goes to Jack Sayak. Ms. Buzard says, I've enjoyed having Jack in our Spanish 3 Advanced Honors class. Jack is a native speaker from Venezuela and is a 9th grader who loves to learn and has a competitive spirit and always tries to excel. He comes to class with a can-do attitude. He's always ready to give each class his best effort and is detail-oriented. He's very interested in maintaining his Spanish-speaking skills as he learns English. I'm excited to see what he will accomplish in the future. And now the Fine Arts Departmental Awards. The Instrumental Music Award goes to Katie Adair. This award is presented to a student who is extremely talented, hardworking, and self-motivating. This student has completed every playing assignment throughout the entire year at a very advanced level. She's an outstanding young musician who plays with a high level of maturity and tone. Congratulations, Katie Adair. The Instrumental Music Award goes to Janie Whitaker. This award is presented to a student who's very talented. This young musician is a beast of a player, has a fabulous positive attitude, and shows outstanding leadership potential. She has excellent sight reading skills and is fully engaged throughout every rehearsal. Congratulations, Janie Whitaker. Ms. Noon is awarding the Most Promising Freshman Theater Student Award to Julia Marcel. Julia brings a radiant energy to the classroom and in rehearsals. She shows a thirst for learning and is always looking for ways to improve her craft. I look forward to seeing her shine on the stage in These Shining Lives and watching her continued growth as an actor. Ms. Noon is presenting Dawson Yates with the Most Promising Theater Student Award. Dawson was unable to join us, but Ms. Noon writes, he shows up to every class ready to learn and ready to push himself to reach new artistic heights. He is the first to dive into new activities, exercises, and opportunities to grow. His encouragement of his classmates and the castmates does not go unnoticed. I'm proud of his journey this year and excited to see him continue to excel through his journey at BHS. Ms. Newton is also awarding the Outstanding Freshman Theater Student Award to Aaron Baker. talented improvisational actor. He's also an extremely supportive classmate. He's always willing, always lending support to his fellow actors, and works to add to a classroom environment where every student is included and welcome. Congratulations. Kaya Shelby earns Miss Payne's Concert Choir Sunshine Award. Miss Payne says that Kaya's energy and positivity is equal to the morning sunshine. I hope she can shine even brighter next year. Oliver Hoskins receives Miss Payne's Concert Choir Most Promising Award. Payne writes, Oliver has impressed me and Mr. Browder with his stage presence and performances this year in choir and in the musical productions of Seussical and Once Upon This Island. Keep up the fantastic work. Amanda Lazo receives Miss Payne's Women's Choir Most Promising Award. She says, Amelia rocks. Amelia is a quiet student who is humble and extremely talented. A cappella choir is so happy you'll be joining. Congratulations. We will finish our departmental awards with Ms. Schneider presenting the Career and Technical Education Award.
I want to circle back to one of the Environmental Science Awards. Gwendolyn Hill, if you could join us. Mr. Connor's Environmental Science Award goes to Gwendolyn Hill. Many times the stronger leader is not the loudest. They are the ones that are dependable, hardworking, and charismatic. Her leadership skills are proven in the classroom and in JROTC. With pride and honor, this award goes to Gwendolyn. Emily Lamb. The Digital Arts and Design Award from Mr. Comer goes to Emily Lamb. Emily produces technically superior digital assignments and always exceeds expectations with the quality of her work. Congratulations. The 9th Grade Business Award goes to Zachary Taylor. Zachary is in our Intro to Business and Marketing 1 classes. Zachary was nominated by Mr. Green and Ms. Onkow. In both classes, he is always enthusiastic to participate. He comes to class always prepared and ready to work. He competed and placed in both DECA district and state conferences. We look forward to his journey in our business and marketing pathways, as well as his future DECA successes. Congratulations. The Business Marketing Award goes to Shannon Krasinski. She is in the Intro to Business and Marketing as well as Marketing 1 and is nominated by Ms. Onkow. She always gives 100% on her assignments and projects. Every assignment or project that she turns in is always above average. Several have even been used by her teachers, Ms. Onkow and Ms. Roberts, as examples for future classes. Congratulations. Dahlia Cersei Willis. The Blackman Agriculture would like to present the Freshman Agriculture Award to Dahlia Cersei Willis. Dahlia is in agri-science this year and has participated in many FFA and ag events. She is hoping to pursue the agriculture pathway in high school with a possible career in agriculture someday. Dahlia is always willing to help and enjoys being part of FFA and ag. Congratulations. Next is Addison Swanner. Ms. Shepherd presents Addison Swanner with the Health Science Award. Addison is an excellent student that has shown a lot of interest in the healthcare field this year. She is an active member of HOSA Club and an all-around great student. We would like to recognize her as our Outstanding Health Science Award winner. Congratulations. Charlie Catron. Mr. Walls presents the Culinary Arts Award to Charlie Catron. She has shown great passion in the culinary arts industry as baking and pastry as her pathway. Her skills and knowledge have great potential in the industry. Congratulations. Braden Flanagan. Mr. Cassidy presents the Criminal Justice Award to Braden Flanagan. Braden is an exceptional freshman criminal justice student that excels academically while keeping a wonderful attitude in class. While in class, he shows signs of leadership and works well with other students. Braden welcomes feedback and takes pride in every aspect of our class. He is eager to learn and always shows up with a smile on his face. Congratulations. Savannah Mejia. Mr. Cassidy presents the Criminal Justice Award to Savannah Mejia. She is an outstanding freshman criminal justice student who's demonstrated a wonderful work ethic and has contributed to the success of our class by being a great role model for her classmates. She has a willingness to learn and welcomes feedback. Her work is well thought out and always on time. Savannah is an enthusiastic learner who enjoys class discussions. Congratulations. Ty Elliott. Mr. Fortell presents the IT Cybersecurity Award to Ty Elliott. He is very involved in his CS Foundations class. He has one of the highest averages across both of the classes, and he is set apart from others by the questions that he asks and his desire to learn more. Congratulations. Rylan Selvage. The STEM 1 award for Mr. Witt goes to Ryan Selvage. Ryan was in the lead for this STEM award since the beginning of the school year. He has many leadership qualities, and many of his classmates already look up to him for guidance. Mr. Witt says, Rylan has excelled this year in my class and will continue to succeed in STEM for years to come. Congratulations. And now I will turn our program over to Dr. Justice, our lead principal.
Ms. Waite, Ms. Paris, Ms. Cravey, and Mr. Walker all wish to express their gratitude for the student council members for their participation and commitment at BHS. Although the school year has provided challenges, the student council leaders have been instrumental in continuing to organize and implement school activities and service projects that help to contribute to our school spirit and community. Their leadership and help have not gone unnoticed as they have adapted and shown what are the best parts of Blackman, our diversity and love for our school. Thank you for your leadership. We have a luggage tag to remind you of your hard work this year. And so as I call your name, if you'll come up and we'll do a picture photo op up here. The freshman class secretary was Nyla Bloomfield. Class vice president is Elise Wabang. And the freshman class president was Kaya Shelby. I do have to say that we've seen some leadership today, and we've seen leadership all year with this freshman class, and it's pretty cool to see. It shows great things are coming. I think one just really event that just kind of showed it to me was the pep rally last week, the move up pep rally. You guys knocked it out of the park with your colors and with your signs and with your spirit, and high five. And Mr. Smith said, you're getting ready to take on a leadership role, and you are, because you have freshmen next year who will come over here and they'll watch you. So continue to do great academic work, continue to be involved in the school, continue to love your school, love one another, love the freshmen as they come over, and help show them what Blackman is all about. You guys, I'm so proud of you today. Congratulations to each and every one of you for winning these awards. Your ninth grade year in high school, which is a tough year. But I would be remiss if I didn't also add that you probably have some people to thank. So today, as you show your awards and talk to your teachers, thank a teacher, because they've put a lot of work into you, plans and preps and feedback and all kinds of things. So thank a teacher. But also, and I'm talking now to the people at home, if you're watching, I know you have family, maybe friends, who have also supported you this year. So when you go home and show this award to them tonight, also take time to thank them for their support. It's been a great year. I appreciate you, and go Blaze.
My name is Alex Trakas. I'm one of the assistant principals here at Blackman. Students, this is a formal ceremony, so please be on your best behavior, and please put your phones away as we acknowledge the achievements of your peers. We started this year by saying the Blaze is back, and there have been numerous events this year that have truly made this year feel normal again. We have had pep rallies, prom was indoors, students were back in the classroom, and students were having fun again. One of the events that make Blackman special are these class awards ceremonies, with students and families gathered together to celebrate all the wonderful accomplishments you all have earned. Thank you for Ms. Jenkins for organizing and planning such a great event. Students, you're about to conclude your first full year of school with all of your peers for the first time since 2019, when you were in the seventh grade. Let that sink in for a second. You've been through so much, for you to sit here today and receive an award for your hard work is credit to you and your family for helping you along the way. Congratulations. We will now begin our departmental awards. Students, if your name is called, please quickly come to accept your award from Mr. Smith, then wait for a picture to be made by one of our student photographers, hopefully. And I will now begin with our English awards. Aubrey Harris. Ms. Boyd is pleased and proud to present the English 2 Honors Award to Aubrey Harris. Aubrey is a highly motivated sophomore student who strives to produce detailed, extensive, and exceptional quality work. She is a role model to her peers in classroom engagement, attentiveness, and positivity. Thank you for your contributions to your learning environment, Aubrey. I am proud of your work ethic. Xavier Wesley. Ms. Hames presents the English 2 Award to Xavier Wesley. Xavier is an outstanding student who has demonstrated excellence in English 2 by maintaining high grades, consistently working hard in class, and mentoring his classmates. Xavier's positive attitude is a joy to be around, and his thoughtful comments in class discussions always add to something positive in our lessons. In addition, Xavier always sets a high bar for self-management of behavior, timeliness, and participation. I have loved having him in class this year, and I know that he will continue to be successful at Blackman and beyond. Caroline Smith. Ms. Boyd is pleased and proud to present the English 2 BCA Award to Caroline Smith. Caroline is a passionate sophomore student who relishes reading, writing, and analysis of texts. Her work is exemplary and extensive, and her projects always impressively go beyond the expectations. Caroline's enthusiasm for pushing her own learning is inspiring. Thank you for your passion and energy in all aspects, Caroline. Ms. Burks would also like to present the Honors Mythology Award to Caroline Smith. Caroline's excitement and enthusiasm permeates everything she does, and this includes her motivation to create a superb semester project and to enjoy the many facets of this class. Abigail Ford. Ms. De La Cruz presents the award for honor speech to Abigail Hoard. Abigail showed a tremendous amount of growth throughout the semester in her speaking and debating skills. I couldn't have been prouder when she successfully debated another team solo, exhibiting both confidence and tenacity. Hanuna Khalil. Hanuna receives the ELD 10 award from Ms. Paris. She says, Hanuna frequently has a positive attitude and pushes herself in her studies. I love getting to see her in classes each day. She helps others and thinks deeply about concepts that are introduced. Jeffrey Sansabath. Ms. Webb presents the Integrated 2 Math Award to Jeffrey. Jeffrey comes to class every day with a great attitude. He has a great work ethic and has been a joy to have in class this year. Lucia Vu. Ms. Brown is presenting the Integrated 2 Math Honors Award to Lucia. Lucia is motivated to put her best into her math. Ethan Broom. Ms. Parcell is presenting the BCA Integrated Math 3 Award to Ethan Broom. Ethan is a curious and dedicated student who manages to impress me repeatedly with his attention to detail and ability to make connections between difficult concepts. I have no doubt that they will go on to make great contributions in the future to STEM or any field that he chooses. Mr. Marcus Lyons, one of our school counselors, will now present the Science Awards.
Good morning. I am Mr. Lyons, one of the school counselors. I'm happy to co-present these awards to such deserving students. Eduardo Loria. Eduardo Loria receives the Biology Award from Ms. Harris. She says, Eduardo is an exceptional student in all aspects. He works diligently every class, is a great example to others, comes in with a smile on his face, and is always respectful. Eduardo has a desire to succeed and is always eager to learn. He possesses such a wonderful growth mindset when it comes to learning. Eduardo is also willing to help his classmates in any way possible. He often helps those around him in various ways. He is truly a great representation of Blackman High and has fully earned this award. Chloe Carreras. Chloe Carreras wins the BCA Honors Chemistry Award from Ms. Bauman. Chloe is a stellar student. Not only does she work to understand the underlying concepts, but she is able to help others master the concepts as well. Chloe always comes to class with a smile and is an absolute pleasure to have in class. I am so excited to see what her future holds. Xavier Wesley. Mr. Weeks presents the Honors Chemistry Award to Xavier Wesley. He says, Xavier has truly excelled in chemistry this year. He is very focused on doing the best that he can. When I began thinking about who should get the award, Xavier immediately came to mind. His work and improvement throughout the school year make him the appropriate recipient of this award. Great job, Xavier. Now we move to the Social Studies Award. Cameron Sujan Kundal. Ms. Jacoby presents the AP Comparative Government and Politics Award to Cameron Sujan, Kundal. Cameron worked very hard all semester in this class, and his grades reflect his hard work. Cameron is always ready with an answer or opinion and eager to help his classmates. Congratulations, Cameron, and I fully expect to see you in my senior government class in the future. Now Mr. Trakas will present the World Language Award.
Alicia Harper. Senor Letson presents the award for Espanol Uno to Alicia Harper. Hopefully I said that right. From August, I have seen Alicia's focused, quiet, sophisticated, poise, and strong demeanor. Her keen attention to detail, self-discipline, and problem-solving skills is a defining line that separates her from her classmates. I see you, Alicia, not just from your intellect. Congratulations, and continue shining your peace from within. Yuridia Gudino. Mrs. Lee is presenting the Honors French 2 Award to Yuridia Gudino. Yuridia always comes to class with a smile. Her enthusiasm and curiosity are contagious, and it is a pleasure to be in her presence. Mercy for you being Yuridia. Paige Frederick. Mrs. Lee is presenting the Advanced Honors French 3 Award to Paige Frederick. I've known Paige for 3 years now, and her enthusiasm for learning French never decreases. Throwing in more French that I don't know how to pronounce, so that's, thank you. Paige's imagination and creativity are truly remarkable. Paige's presence is a ray of sunshine in French class. Ayana Dunbar. Senora Krauss is presenting the Honors Spanish 2 Award to Ayana Dunbar. Ayana has been a great student to have in Spanish. She asks questions, volunteers, and participates in the classroom. She is not embarrassed to ask for help. Her Spanish has been spot on since day one. I am glad to have the pleasure of teaching Ayana this year. Paige Turner. The Honors Spanish 4 Award goes to Paige Turner. Ms. Bouzard says, Paige is a pleasure to have in class. She has true grit and has been able to keep up with the native speakers in the class. She is very talented and exceptional student who is very attentive and dedicated to showing her best each day. She goes the extra mile to ensure that she submits quality work in a timely manner. I am excited to see her soar and her abilities to use the language in her life and future. I wish she could continue studying Spanish with me, as she has 2 more years to go in high school. Paige, please stop by anytime and visit and practice your Spanish. Marciana Johnson. Mr. Doherty is presenting the Latin One Award to Marciana Johnson. Marciana has a true passion for the Latin language and the ancient people of Rome. She is definitely not afraid to share her thoughts and views, as she is very vocal about them. We have had our fair share of passionate discussions, and her passion reminds me of myself. She is truly one of the hardest working people I know. I can't wait until Latin 2 next year with Marciana, because I'm always looking forward to our discussions and exchanging of ideas. I have learned a lot from her already, and I want to thank you for a great year. And now for the Fine Arts Departmental Awards. Chloe Schmidt. Chloe receives the Instrumental Music Award. This award is presented to the student who is hardworking, dedicated, and talented. This musician made mid-state and received a coveted seat in the 9th and 10th grade Tennessee All-State Band. She practices all the time and is an outstanding role model. Congratulations, Chloe. Benjamin Vonserath. The Instrumental Music Award goes to Benjamin. This award is presented to a student who has shown tremendous progress over the past two years. He is very talented and is a key member of our band. This young man has an outstanding leadership potential, a positive attitude, and a strong work ethic. Congratulations to you, Benjamin. Nadia Tooley. Ms. Noon is awarding the Most Promising Sophomore Theater Student Award to Nadia Tooley. Nadia is a hardworking student who goes above and beyond in the classroom and on the stage. Her kindness, positivity, and talents will carry her far in her scholastic and theater career. I am excited to see where the next 2 years take her. Zibiner Turfan. I'm so sorry. Please don't hurt me. Miss Noon is awarding the Outstanding Sophomore Theater Student to Zibiner Turfan. Zibiner is a student who is first to show up and last to leave every paint call. She is dedicated, motivated, and above all, has been an asset to the process of the scenic painting. I am very thankful for her hard work and always showing up. Keep up the great work. Ailey Gardner. The Musical Theater Award goes to Ailey Gardner. Being in Seussical, the musical, Ailey has a brightness that lights up the stage when she performs. Her audition for Once on This Island was breathtaking. Tristan Hansen. Tristan Hansen receives Mrs. Payne's Concert Choir Award. Tristan's enthusiasm and work ethic are absolutely wonderful and contagious. This year, Tristan has proven to be a great leader, and I'm looking forward to next year. Shania Williams. Shania Williams earns Miss Payne's Women's Choir Award. She says, Shania is a true example of what a dedicated and hardworking student should resemble. I am so happy to see you next year in the musical productions and an a cappella choir. Toby Commodore. Toby Commodore wins Miss Payne's Most Promising A Cappella Choir Award. Miss Payne says, this gentleman is truly remarkable. Toby is a reader, a dancer, in JROTC, and such a great singer. I have never seen such a dedicated brother and overall good person. Keep up the good work and get ready for your leadership roles. Sebastian Maynard. Mr. Carter presents the Art One Award to Sebastian Maynard, a and Mr. Carter wrote, "He is a very hardworking and talented artist and student. Sebastian works every day from bell to bell and has been a model student for the entire year." Elijah Brown. Elijah Brown receives a Drawing and Painting Award from Ms. Anderson. Elijah is a special joy to have as an art student. He is constantly exploring new ways to make art and has already developed a recognizable artistic style as a sophomore. He's also the most courteous teenager you will ever meet. We will finish the departmental awards with Mr. Lyons presenting the Career and Technical Education Awards.
Thank you. Addie Cobb. Addie Cobb receives the Business Award from Ms. Covington. She says, "Addie excels in the classroom and is a perfect example of a business student. She is always willing to work hard and help others in the process." Maddie Myers. Maddie Myers is presented the Business Award from Ms. Covington. Maddie has been an integral part of the Blaze Bookstore this year. From managing and selling, she is always on task and leading others. Chase Stanfield. The Sophomore Marketing Award goes to Chase Stanfield. Chase is enrolled in Marketing 2 and Banking and Finance. Chase was nominated by both Mrs. Knopfsinger and Mrs. Roberts. Chase is an excellent student that goes above and beyond normal expectations in the classroom, on assignments, and outside the classroom. Chase maintains straight A's in all business and marketing classes and always turns in exceptional work. Chase is a prime example of the Blackman way. Albany Rubio. The Sophomore Marketing Award goes to Albany Rubio. Albany is enrolled in Marketing 1 with Mr. Green. Albany is always engaged in class and willingly participates in all classroom assignments and activities. She has demonstrated a willingness to give up her time to translate for the non-English speaking students at Blackman High School. Thank you. Albany also is very involved in DECA. She competed at the state conference in a team decision-making event. She was also chosen by Tennessee DECA to represent Blackman High School in the Emerging Leadership Series at DECA ICDC. We look forward to her future DECA endeavors. Matthew Sanchez. Blackman Agriculture is proud to present the Sophomore Award to Matthew Sanchez. Matthew is enrolled in Plant and Soil Science and Greenhouse Management. Matthew takes an active role in securing the success of the greenhouse by watering and monitoring the plants to ensure they have a healthy growing environment. Matthew is an active FFA member and has represented Blackman Ag in Raider Roundup at MTSU. Congratulations, Matthew. Phoebe Benton. Blackman Agriculture would like to recognize Phoebe Benton as an outstanding sophomore due to her willingness to jump in and assist in any situation that arises in agriscience. Phoebe has secured her place in the Blackman Agriculture by working with others and being a leader when called upon. Congratulations, Phoebe. Mitt Patel. Dr. Jones is presenting the Honors Medical Therapeutics Award to Mitt Patel. Mitt has been an outstanding and exceptional student this year. He always has a positive attitude and a genuine personality. Mitt comes to class with a smile every day and really sets the tone in class that we are here to work and have fun. He works hard, has the aspiration to do his best, and doesn't mind helping his peers. I'm so excited to see what the future holds for him. I know he will do great things in his life, and I'm proud to call him my student. Jordan Johnson. Mr. Penix presents the Culinary Arts Award to Jordan Johnson. Jordan has shown great skills and leadership as she grows in the culinary arts pathway and understands the necessary devotion and passion needed for this field. Braylon Trail. Ms. Brown is presenting the Coding One Award to Braylon Trail. Braylon is a creative and resourceful coder who lets his curiosity push him forward. He is a truly gifted coder. Ian Martin. Ms. Head is presenting the AV1 Award to Ian Martin. Ian has been a difference maker in the AV department. He consistently volunteered for photography and video projects that capture our best moments of the year. We look forward to seeing what his future years at Blackman will bring as he further develops his skills. Hannah Neal. Hannah Neal is a tour de force when it comes to video and sound. All right. She takes an idea and runs with it to completion. Hannah was a driving force behind the TSSAA and the No Trash November video contest, of which Blackman High won a substantial award. Hannah has the maturity of someone much older. For her, the next 2 years will be very exciting to watch as she continues to grow in her skills in the audiovisual realm. Congratulations, Hannah, on being selected as the Audiovisual 2 Student of the Year. L. Jack Carlin. Ms. Head is presenting the Digital Arts and Design 2 Award to L. Jack Carlin. Ellis demonstrated an impressive ability to edit video. She went above and beyond class requirements to support the needs of Blackman Media. We are excited to see her skills expand as her passion for digital arts drives her to take on new challenges. Rudra Patel. Rudra Patel receives the IT Cybersecurity Award from Mr. Fortell. Rudra is very quiet, but he is quite knowledgeable when it comes to the networks class. He has shown a great aptitude for technology as it pertains to networks. Toler Griffin. Mr. Cassidy presents the Criminal Justice Award to Toler Griffin. Toler is this year's outstanding sophomore criminal justice student. Toler possesses a great work ethic and excels academically. He takes pride in the level of work he completes and can be a role model for fellow students. I will now turn the program over to our assistant principal, Mr. Justin Smith, ladies and gentlemen.
The final group of students that we want to recognize today are our student council officers. Ms. Waite, Ms. Paris, Ms. Cravey, and Mr. Walker all wish to express their gratitude to the student council members for their participation and commitment to BHS. Although the school year has provided challenges, these student council leaders have been instrumental in continuing to organize and implement school activities and service projects that help to contribute to our school spirit and community. Their leadership and help have not gone unnoticed as they have adapted and shown what are the best parts of Blackman, our diversity and our love for our school. Thank you for your leadership. We have a luggage tag to remind you of your hard work this year. If the following students would please come forward. Alan Green. Fatima Fall. Haley Gardner. Hannah Neal. And Hamza Farid. Students, we could not be more proud of your accomplishments and your work. As we look forward to your next 2 years at Blackman High School, we know that the future is bright, and we look forward to your hard work and your leadership in our school. Thank you so much. This concludes our program, and now we'll report to third period. Thank you all.
If you win a math or an English award, will you stay so we can take your picture? I don't think we got your pictures, and your parents might be disappointed. So, math and English people, come to the front. We'll take a fast picture for you.
Junior award ceremony, and if you are here, it's an honor for you to be here. We're here to recognize some outstanding achievement. I do want to remind you that this is a formal ceremony, so please, if you would, put your cell phones away, be on your best behavior, just to give your peers the attention and the recognition that they deserve. And before we begin, I do want to just take a moment to tell you congratulations on your hard work and the effort. It's your first year, full year back in school. So this year was different than it has been the last couple of years. And it was nice, but it also presented challenges for you as students, for teachers, for everyone in the building. And yet you have persevered and rose to the top. So you're to be congratulated for that. Also, here in just a few days, you're going to be the seniors and the leaders of our school. And so we look to you for next year to set the tone all across the board. And those below you will watch you and see how you respond and you react to the challenges and the opportunities that lie ahead. So we know you're going to do wonderful, great things next year, but here we're going to celebrate your accomplishments and your achievements for this year. Okay? If your name is called, we'll ask you to come quickly to accept your award from Dr. Justice. Then wait for a picture to be made by one of our photographers. Okay? And so we will now begin with the English awards. Okay? Mrs. Sapu is presenting the English 3 award to Alea Alexander. Alea comes to class ready to work every day and has stood out thanks to her dedication and focus. Alea never allows her involvement in extracurriculars to get her behind, displaying an ability to balance responsibilities that will take her far in life. Congratulations. Ms. Vu is presenting the Honors English 3 Award to Sarah Ewells. Sarah is one of the hardest workers I've seen in my career. If she does not understand something, she will work until she does, seeking to understand the material rather than just to get a grade. That consistent commitment will serve her well as she moves forward in her endeavors. Congratulations. The Honors English 3 BCA Award is presented by Ms. Griggs to Madeline Winningham. Maddie is a self-motivated student who puts forth her best effort with every assignment. She seeks advice when needed, meets deadlines, reads outside of class, and grows academically each quarter. She is engaged in group work and willing to help classmates. I look forward to hearing of her future success. Ms. Griggs presents the AP English 3 Award to Dylan Weiniger. Dylan challenges himself to improve as a reader and a writer both inside and outside of class. His writing reflects significant improvement this year in both the depth of his analysis and his use of rhetorical strategies and critical thinking skills. He thinks outside of the box, works hard to improve, and is one of the brightest minds at Black. I can't wait to hear of his future success. Tao Nguyen received the English 4 ESL Award from Ms. Paris. Ms. Paris says, Tao is new to our school this year, but she has excelled in every way. She is so polite and respectful to me as well as other students. She really tries her best on every single assignment. She is so helpful to others, and our class has benefited from her presence. Congratulations. Here. Okay. And now for the math awards. Campbell Lafort receives Mr. Baker's Integrated 3 Math Award from Mr. Baker. Campbell, are you here? Nope. No Campbell. Okay. So we'll hang on to this for Campbell. Riley Harris wins the Integrated 3 Math Award from Mr. Baker. In a class of outstanding students, Riley stood out even more. She was always quick with an answer, eager to learn, and a step ahead, even when things seemed to come easy, which with Riley they often did. She was always working hard. She was never satisfied with mere perfection, driving her average above 100% every quarter. She is one of the most impressive math students Mr. Baker has had the honor to teach. Congratulations. Ms. Webb presents the Honors Pre-Calculus Award to Alyssa Pringano. Alyssa has been a joy to have in class and works extremely hard every class period. She has shown great aptitude for mathematics. Congratulations. Ms. Swanson, one of our counselors, will now present the Science Awards.
Hello, guys. I'm Ms. Swanson. I've had the honor to be with you guys the last 2 years, and this year we changed, but I'm still have a lot of you in my heart that aren't in my alphabet A through D, so I'm glad to be here with all the juniors today. We're going to start with science. Let's see. Christian Lewis receives the AP Chemistry Award. Come on, Christian. Christian's not here. Okay. Joshua Schweikert, come on down. Joshua receives the Conceptual Physics Award from Miss Dawson. Joshua has been a class leader and helps others to understand how to work problems in physics. He works hard to maintain his A average while showing an interest by going more in depth. Congratulations. Michael Gordon. Okay, Michael. Amira Hiawat Herrera. Mr. Weeks presents the Chemistry Award to Amira. He says there was no doubt as to who would receive the Chemistry Award this year. Amira is an excellent student. She works hard, always striving to improve, and it has been wonderful watching her grow this year. I'm proud of her accomplishments, and I know that she will go on to bigger and better achievements. Good job, Amira. Evan Grant. The Physical Science Award goes to Evan Grant from Coach Better. Evan is a junior and is an outstanding young man that carries the highest overall grade in all physical science classes. He shows up to school every day, performs well in all his assignments, and helps other classmates when they need help. Evan attends and participates in school activities while performing at a high level in all classes. Great job, Evan. Josiana Tango. Ms. Wilson is pleased to award the Physics 1 Award to Josiana Tango. She has worked hard all year to obtain an understanding of both the math and concepts that underlie a quality understanding of physics. She has a commitment to excellence in her studies, and it is shown in the winning of this award. I know that she will continue to do well in all she pursues. Congratulations again to Josiana on the body of work she has done in Physics 1. Congratulations. Now we move to social studies. Grace Shimbaugh. Emily Dye. Emily Dye is awarded the Dual Enrollment American History Award from Mr. Shimbaugh. He says Emily is a rock star in Dual Enrollment US. Her questions are always on point and add so much to the classroom discussions. Don't go anywhere. Okay. Emily is also awarded the Bronze Good Citizenship Medal from Mr. Shimbaugh and the Sons of the American Revolution. He says Emily always brings a highly infectious, sunny disposition to all of her group settings. Congratulations. Jada Dye. Jada receives the Dual Enrollment American History Award from Mr. Shimbaugh. Jada's helper cards can be considered modern art. She frequently has the highest summative scores and is super diligent in her preparation. Again, don't go anywhere. Jada also receives the Bronze Good Citizenship Medal from Mr. Shimbaugh and the Sons of the American Revolution. He says Jada inspires those around her to do more and to do better. Congratulations. Karina Patel. Mr. Shimbaugh presents the AP U.S. History Award to Karina Patel. He says she is consistently the touchstone of the class in terms of quality of work and achievement. Congratulations. Jacob Hanna. Jacob, Mr. Shimbaugh presents you with the U.S. History Award. He is the sharpest U.S. history student at Blackman High School, says Mr. Shimbaugh. His inquisitive nature and his maturity of thought are evidenced by his scores and his contributions to class. Congratulations, Jacob. Nadia Hember. Mr. Sapu presents the Honors U.S. History Award to Nadia Ember. Nadia has been one of the hardest workers within Honors U.S. History this year. I look forward to seeing you graduate next year, and I have no doubt that you will become successful in whatever you choose to do in the future. Thank you for being an outstanding student. Sophia Suarez. Mr. Jones presents the Economic Government Award to Sophia Suarez. Sophia participates in all classroom discussions. She guides her peers during group assignments by contributing excellent academic work while helping others do the same. She retained the information and can recall prior learning. Sophia is a kind person who always has positive interactions with her peers and teachers. Sophia is a joy to have in the classroom. Amira Hiawa Herrera. Mr. Jones presents the U.S. History Award to Amira. Amira displays all the qualities of an ideal student. She participates, pays attention, and completes all of her assignments with quality work. She always wants to understand the topics on a deeper level and makes connections on today's world through historical topics. She is also polite and kind when dealing with her peers and teachers. She is a pleasure to have in class and in the student body. And now Mr. Lawless will present the World Language Awards.
So before we begin with the World Language Award, we'd like to award for Michael Gordon. If you'd come on down. Wilson is pleased to present the AP Physics 2 Award to Michael. He's done a wonderful job in both learning the math and concepts needed to be well prepared for future work in physics. Michael has a desire for excellence in all that he does, and I'm thankful to have worked with him over the past 2 years. Congratulations to Michael on earning this well-deserved award. Ms. Lee is presenting the Advanced Honors French 4 Award to Sakina Camara. Ms. Lee is presenting French 2 Award to Vanessa Crissell. Vanessa always comes to class ready, and if not, she's hiding it well, and eager to learn and help her classmates. She shows patience and understanding and makes everyone at ease in class. I do hope she continues learning French as it comes naturally to her. Congratulations. Mr. Doherty is presenting the Latin 2 Award to Evan Peterson. Evan. And now the Fine Arts Awards. The Instrumental Music Award goes to Riley Harris. This award is presented to a student who is extremely talented, self-motivated, and has meticulous work ethic. She is a key player in both the concert and jazz ensemble and leads with confidence and maturity. This young musician is also a great leader who loves the band and is very dedicated to help the band reach the next level of success. Congratulations. The Instrumental Music Award is presented to Keegan Scott. Keegan is a student who is hardworking, dedicated, and talented. He has exceptional leadership skills and is committed to excellence on the concert stage and football field. This young musician is an excellent role model who treats others with respect, works until the job is done correctly, and has an amazing level of hype and blaze band spirit. Congratulations. The Most Promising Theater Student Award is presented to Luke Gentry. From the moment he played Peter Pan, Luke has been granting us with the pleasures of his performance. From the major of Whoville or being a storyteller, Luke is our most promising actor. He stars as Tom in this year's productions of These Shining Five. Congratulations. The Outstanding Theater Student Award goes to Jarrett Royer. Jarrett is the rock star of the drama department. While being supportive of others and working hard at his craft, Jarrett has become one of the strongest and most audacious young actors that Mr. Browder has ever seen. Jarrett will also be going to Tennessee Governor's School of the Arts. Congratulations. The Musical Theater Award is presented to Justin Collins. A diva is only a bad word if you cannot pack it up with enormous amounts of talent. I didn't write these. Justin is a diva in a good way. He made All-State in acting on his first attempt. He made Tennessee Governor's School of the Arts. He has been the lead in two productions this year. Again, Justin is a diva and deserves the Musical Diva Theater Award. Olivia Suggs is the recipient of the Musical Theater Award. Playing Gertrude McFuzz in Seussical gave the audience a little appetizer of what Olivia's voice and stage presence could bring. But when she glowed up by portraying Ezeli in Once Upon the Island, she served up talent that was cathartic to the audience. Congratulations. Maddison Wurzler receives the Clay Award. Madison is a very engaged art student. She supervised and helped paint the large Goblaze mural in the front lobby this year, assisted with other extracurricular art activities. Her personal artwork exceeds expectations, and we can always count on her as a leader in the art room. Congratulations. Okay, we will finish the department awards with Ms. Swanson presenting Career and Technical Education Awards.
Victor Huerva. The Junior Business Award goes to Victor. He is in the Accounting Department of Virtual Enterprise. He has been very instrumental in a lot of the VE successes this year. He is very thorough in his work and creative as well as innovating in problem solving. He competed in the Virtual Enterprise National QuickBooks Competition and made it to round two of the national competition. He will be tested for his QuickBooks certification test soon. He also competed at both the district and state level of competition for DECA. He is a 3-year member and competitor of DECA. Congratulations. The Junior Marketing Award goes to Brooke McFarland. The Redstone Student of the Year Award goes to Evan Grant. Throughout the year, Evan has shown leadership and dedication. He has an excellent work ethic and has knowledge of all aspects of operating the bridge at Blackman High School. Numerous times, he has worked with other students to work through problems and answer questions. He continuously showed up to fulfill his responsibilities and beyond. Congratulations. Genesis Hartman. Troy Willish. Ms. Shepherd presents Troy with the Rehabilitation Careers Award. Troy has shown that he is truly passionate about rehab careers, both in his enthusiasm and willingness to learn this year. He always works hard and is eager to participate in the hands-on learning experience in class. He stands out above the rest. We would like to recognize him as the Rehabilitation Careers Award winner. Congratulations. Olivia Cooner. Mm-hmm. Ms. Slade says the most outstanding honors anatomy and physiology student award goes to Olivia Cooner for her dedication in the field of healthcare. Olivia is the very attentive in class and genuinely interested in the subject matter. She is a lovely young lady and has truly been a pleasure having her in class. Dr. Jones is presenting the Honors Medical Therapeutics Award to Mitt Patel. Mitt has been an outstanding and exceptional student this year. He always has a positive attitude and a genuine personality. Mitt comes to class with a smile every day and really sets the tone in class. That we are here to work and have fun. He works hard, has aspirations to do his best, and doesn't mind helping his peers. I'm so excited to see what the future holds for him. I know he will do great things in his life, and I'm proud to call him my student. Congratulations. Tessa Wallace. Mr. Penix presents the Culinary Award to Tessa Wallace. She has learned the skills and knowledge in the culinary arts industry to become a great asset, not only in cooking, but also in baking and preparing pastries, both in competition and in the kitchen. Congratulations. Ms. Brown is presenting the Coding to Award to Alyssa Keanu. Alyssa's brilliant creativity guides her to amazing creations. She is a hard, independent worker and makes it seem effortless. Congratulations. Chandler LeMay. Chandler receives the IT Cybersecurity Award from Mr. Fortell. Chandler is a great leader in the cybersecurity class. He is always ahead of everyone else in finishing work and then looking for more. He certified for Dell Student Tech Crew in just 2 days. He will be the top senior in the practicum class next year. Congratulations. Zane Abirov. The STEM 3 Award for Mr. Witt goes to Zane. Zane has stepped into a leadership position this year in my STEM class. He is always the first one to volunteer and step up when something needs to be done. He has guided others during projects and taking on some complicated problems in which he has solved successfully. He thinks outside the box and works very hard on everything he does. He has a positive attitude and great attention to detail. Zane very much deserves this STEM award. Congratulations. Abdul Haizai. Now I will turn the program over to Dr. Justice, our principal.
At this time, we'd like to recognize our student council officers. And so if you're here, if you could come up. We'll start, I'll read about it first. You got to come up. If you're here, come up. Ms. Paris, Ms. Cravey, and Mr. Walker all wish to express their gratitude for the student council members for their participation and commitment to BHS. Although this school year has provided challenges, these student council leaders have been instrumental in continuing to organize and implement school activities and service projects that help contribute to our school spirit and community. Their leadership and help have not gone unnoticed as they have adapted and shown what are the best parts of Blackman, our diversity and our love for our school. Thank you for your leadership. We have a luggage tag for you to remind you of your hard work this year. So, Ranelli Kumamboy. And Andrea but just a couple of comments to all of your students. This is the last awards presentation that I'll make as principal of this high school. I'm kind of sad that I won't see what you do next year, but I'll stay in touch and find out about the great things that you do. I would just encourage you to take the success that's in this room, take the energy that's in this room, take the positivity that's in this room, because you guys, this is a large group. You can make an impact on next year. So please go and have a great senior year. Y'all, you got here because you worked hard or because you're talented in certain areas, but you have, besides yourself, to thank, you probably have some other people. So as you go and share these awards today with your family, friends, and teachers, make sure that you tell them that you understand their support helped you get here. Y'all have a great day, and go Blaze.